Do you know that pathological Q waves may be not only due to myocardial infarction? They may be observed in the patients with functioning accessory pathways. And which diseases should be suspected when pathological Q waves are intermittent? Pathological Q waves are the main ECG sign of myocardial infarction, but sometimes they can appear in the Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. This is a syndrome that is characterized by a functioning accessory pathway that communicates between the atria and ventricles in addition to the atrioventricular node. Such accessory pathway is called as a bundle of Kent. Atrioventricular node prevents the ventricles from too frequent impulses of supranodal origin. Also, it causes some physiological delay between atrial and ventricular contractions. During this delay, atria contract and the blood is ejected into the ventricles. In the case of Kent bundle functioning, impulses generated in the sinus node or other parts of atria come faster to the ventricles. There is no physiological delay. ECG shows it as a shortened PR interval, because the impulse is conducted faster via the accessory pathway. Also, there is a delta wave, which is slurred upstroke in the QRS complex. So ventricles are activated by impulses conducted by both accessory pathway and via the atrioventricular node. The QRS complex consists of fusion between the early ventricular activation caused by conduction via the accessory pathway and the late ventricular activation caused by impulses conducted via the atrioventricular node. This leads to slurring of the upstroke of the QRS complex. The slurring is called delta wave. The QRS complex becomes somewhat prolonged. When we see many ECGs recorded in certain patients at which pathological Q waves appear and disappear, we cannot think about myocardial infarction, as in this case Q waves are permanent. Pre-excitation is one of the most common causes of intermittent non-infarction Q waves. Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome may mimic myocardial infarction pattern. The presence and the location of the Q waves are determined by the factor of delta wave. Often, delta wave is oriented superiorly. It causes pathological Q waves in the inferior leads because of change in the direction of depolarization forces. If the delta wave is oriented to the right, Q waves appear in lead 1. If conduction is relatively slow and is similar to the conduction via AF node and bundle of His, PR interval may remain normal, but the widening of QRS complex may be obvious. So non-specific widening of QRS complex from 0.1 to 0.12 seconds and intermittent pathological Q waves may be the first signs of latent Wolff-Parkinson-White syndrome. Also, it's important to know intermittent pre-excitation, which is characterized by transitory functioning of an accessory pathway, leading to transient ECG changes such as delta waves, prolonged the QRS duration, shortening of the PR interval.